Okay, I have what's called an umbrella urn, and this is a huge Italian urn. That's right, it's made in Italy. Let me go ahead and show you the bottom first. On the bottom, it's marked, it's actually scratched into the pottery, made in Italy. And then, of course, it's got the tag from the Great Indoors, that's Sears. $129 was the retail price on this pot. You can see that it's terracotta ware. What do they call that? Greenware, I guess. Greenware is before they glaze it. Now, these polka dots that are on here, those are actually nude spots on the glaze. That's probably called some reverse something or other, because instead of putting the polka dots, they painted everything but the polka dots. It's got two looped handles. Now, I'm going to say this handle broke off in shipping, and I repaired it. That's going to be the condition of it. And if I didn't tell you that, you probably wouldn't know it. Of course, as a collector's item, that kind of shoots down any value that it has. Originally, it was made as an umbrella stand. It's pretty heavy. It's very sturdy. You can see that by looking inside, you can see that that was handmade. It's got that coil construction. Do you get a shot in there where you can see the coils? Are we getting, can you see the little coil design in there? Just like in school when you made your first pot, that's how they made this. You can tell it's handmade. That's probably accounts for the $130 price on it. Call and give me a bid on this. The next item I have is a 24-inch pedestal. It's in a cherry finish, and I don't know what you call that design, almost gothic. How about that? I think I got it that time, gothic. You know the way I do that? I just clear my head, and then the first word that pops in is how you do it? Uh-huh. No, you're just humoring me. All right, this pedestal, again, 24 inches tall. It's in a dark cherry finish. There's a condition I need to tell you about. Some of the cherry veneer on this item cracked off, and I repaired it with shoe polish. That looks good, though, doesn't it? You can't. And you know what? Put that in the back. Ooh, look at the price on that item. $149. Excuse me. $149. That urn sure did look good sitting on top of it. See, that's why I had those little carpeted pieces. Call and give me a bid. Hey, I got a backpack for you. This is in the pink color, floral design, padded back straps. This only has two pockets, so perhaps this might be for younger children. $15 retail price right there from Kmart. Call and give me a bid. I got a DVD player, which is the same one they sell at the Family Dollar Store. This comes with a remote control. It does play DVDs, CDs, CD-RWs, and even JPEGs. It's a DVD player with remote control. They sell it at Family Dollar for $30. You call and give me a bid. Above that, I've got some 15-ounce coolers. These come in three colors. One of them broke. I've got the red, the tan, and the blue. Three glasses for one money. I've got a carabiner misting fan. You fill this with water like you would a water pistol, and when you press that trigger, it sprays a mist through the fan. It runs off of I don't remember if that's AA or AAA. It's about a $4 retail price. Call and tell me what that item's worth. Also on the table, I have some mini DVD-Rs. There are camcorders, little camcorders that record directly onto these. These will also play back directly in your computer DVD drives. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them, each with its own jewel pack. This is by Memorex. They're mini DVD-Rs, and they retail for about $20. Also on the table, I have some welding goggles for you. These welding goggles, you're bidding on three pair of them. And they do have an adjustable bridge in the center. They have an elastic band on the back. They've got really dark green filters that you can take off. You could even use these as clear safety goggles. They're ventilated on the side. You're bidding on three pair for one money. Hey, I got a halogen leak detector. And don't let that name, you would say, when in the world do I mess with halogen gas? What kind of leaks you really detect with this is Freon leaks. So you would use this to detect a leak in like your R13, your R12, and your R22 Freon type gases. It's got a visual and an audible alarm. And I'm thinking this device, it's got like a little sniffer on the end of it. And you could actually locate the where the leak is occurring. Check your different junctions till you find the leak. This is a very valuable tool if you're an AC repairman. You would use it on refrigerators, freezers, anything that has what y'all call refrigerated air. Your automobile as well. It's a $70 retail price. I've got a decorative speedboat for you. This is a wood construction. The windshield is broke, so I think maybe what was the name of that wild movie star that used to ride around in those? He took his boat to Acapulco, and he started Acapulco. There was a movie star that started Acapulco, you know.
Really?
It was just a village. And he was real famous, and he had a sailing yacht, and that he would park it to this, cruise it to this little village and park it. And then, of course, all the movie stars started hanging out. Oh, you know, kind of like George Clooney is doing with that little Italian lake, and he has the villa on the same thing. What movie star was that, man? It wasn't Clark Gable. It was before him. Do you know, sir? We're trying to think of that movie star. Okay. Oh, that's way too long. That's the 10 items on the table. We ain't got time for chit-chat. Let's go to the bidder board. And he had a big trial because there was a 14-year-old girl on his boat that